Hello, good morning students. Today I am here to discuss with you the second chapter of your economics books of class 10, that is sectors of Indian economy. Before understanding the sectors of Indian economy, let me first explain you what is Indian economy. Do anybody know what is Indian economy? Any guesses? Okay, let me tell you. Indian economy is a developing plus mixed economy, and let me tell you why we call it developing. Developing because India, there are three types of nations. First is developed, second stage is developing, and the third is underdeveloped. Let me relate you these three with an example, that is developed, developing and underdeveloped. Let me take the example of India itself. When we talk of different country or different states in India, we talk of three types: developed, developing and underdeveloped. So I can say Bangalore or our metropolitan cities, Mumbai, these come in the category of developed. Second, developing, let us take an example, Uttar Pradesh itself, Rajasthan, and when we talk of underdeveloped, that is Bihar, Odisha. So what can we see from these examples of cities of India under the developed, developing and underdeveloped states, that is Bangalore and Mumbai. When we talk of Bangalore and Mumbai, there are facilities, each and everything is provided in hand, but all the facilities are being developed, and in developing the government is trying to develop these, so that's why they are known as developing. And underdeveloped, where they have to pose developing stage and then they'll reach the developed stage. Same happens with India. We call India a developing country because India is in the middle. Before 1990s, India was a underdeveloped country. Then it took certain policies, it took certain decisions and improved its literacy rate, employment rate, infant mortality rate, and reach this level of developing nations. Then it comes to then the stage which will in India will possess in future is developed nation. Suppose if a person is working in a bank, it has regular terms and conditions of employment. Let me write here. For example, he knows that he'll get a leave of first and fourth Saturday and Sundays and gazetted holidays, and his regular timings of work would be predefined, that he has to reach bank at 10 and leave the bank at 5 or 6. So that is the rules and policy of organized sector. That is a plus point of the organized sector, that it contains regular terms and conditions of employment. Besides this, unorganized sector has no rules regarding this. Unorganized sectors do not have any regular terms and conditions of employment. It does include the timings, it does include the safety, it does include the paying norms, but it has no rules. The timings are not fixed, the salary is not fixed according to a grade, and the workers do not get gazetted holidays. They do not enjoy safety and security in the organization. That is the unorganized sector. Second, it has some formal procedures. When a person is being employed in a bank, he has to go through an exam, he has to go through an interview with respect to his respective degrees. But in an organized sector, there is no such condition. There is no such condition that they have to face exam, they have to do certain norms, they have to fulfill certain procedures, they have to work upon certain policies. There is no such rule in the unorganized sector. Then let's come to payment. Payment refers very much in organized sector. As we can see, a bank employee earns much more than a street vendor. So in organized sectors, The workers, the men, are highly paid, whereas in unorganized sectors they are low paid. And low paid, so therefore we can take an example that banker is working in an organized sector, while a street vendor or a labor is working in a unorganized sector. A street vendor on a labor. So let's recapitulate what these two sectors of the Indian economy are: unorganized and organized. Unorganized is regular terms of employment, and there are in unorganized there are no such rules of unemployment. In formal, the unorganized sector there is a formal procedure, but in unorganized sector there are no such conditions. Again, in organized sector the workers are highly paid, but in unorganized sectors the workers are low paid and they are street vendors or laborers.